हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर रिचा शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग, पंजाबी यूनिवर्सिटी पटियाला। हेयर आई एम डिस्कसिंग हाउ टू यूज गूगल मीट, हाउ टू क्रिएट गूगल क्लासरूम एंड सम मोर एप्लीकेशंस। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, फॉर क्रिएटिंग द गूगल क्लासरूम वी शुड हैव अवर जीमेल अकाउंट, एज आई हैव क्रिएटेड अ जीमेल अकाउंट इन विच दिस टाइप ऑफ page is open and these grids are open, which are the Google apps. When I click on this, these options are there, and if I go on down, there is a classroom option. I click on this, this page will open. As I have already two classes there, I am telling you how to create a class. There is a plus sign, click on that plus sign. There are two options: join class, create class. As we are teacher, we have to create the class for the students, and if I am a student, then I have to join the class. Let's say create a class. When I click on this, this is open. I click on this, then continue. It will ask the details how of your class, name of the class, let's say BTech first year ECE. Let section, it is asking A1. I'm putting the sections for which I'm creating the class. Subject, let's say BEE. BEE lab. Then it is asking online class. Then go to create. It will take some time for creating the class. So this will open. Your class is created, BTech first year. You are having here option for in the settings, you can correct it and put the save. So this is your class which is created. There are four options: stream, classroom, people, grades. So I have created class BTech first year ECE. Groups are A1, A2, A3, and this is the class code. When I click on this, this will open. When I copy this link and I will share this link with the students, and when with this link the students can join the class, as you can share it on the WhatsApp group or you can mail them, fine. And as I'm showing you, the students who are having joined my class already, for example, this is BTech A7 8 group of ECM, electronics and computer engineering. So when I click on the people, it shows that the number of students who have joined the class. Here 46 students have joined my class. These are the list of the students. So the students who are having the Gmail account can join your class by clicking on the link which you have shared with them. So there are the options. When you click all, there is action. You can email to all the students. You can remove any student or you can mute any student. For example, I click on the email. It will open. Whatever the information I want to send or any notes, I can make the attachment file, and all the notes or attachment is sent to all the students in one go. if I want to share the Google Meet link, I click on here, I put the link here and send to the students. So this is how we are creating. Second option is, this is how we are using the people, and this shows how many students we are having in the class. Then there is stream. Stream means what you are having, the main view of your Google Classroom. Fine, this is upcoming. Upcoming means what assignments you have given to the students, how many students have submitted that. Everything is shown here, as there is no no assignment is given yet, so nothing is appeared here. To review or reviewed means that have you checked that assignment or not. Going back, this is classwork. Classwork means when you have to send the assignment or notes to the students. Here you if you want to create the assignment, then you click on here, assignment. You can make, send them assignment, you can put the quiz here, you can put the questions, you can put the material, notes, topics, anything you can put here. When you click on here, any that thing will be created. Means let's say I want to create an assignment for the students, that is created here. How many marks, due date, topic, everything is there. For which student, how many points you want to give, date of submission, topic name, all these are fine. So this is how you create the assignment, quiz, or you put the notes here. Then you are having the grades. When you check the assignments, all the grades comes here. So this is for the teacher's record, which students have submitted the assignment, which students have not submitted. Everything is visible here. This is visible only to the teacher who have created the class. So this is how to create a class. So in this I have created three classes, in which it shows the groups, number of students, everything. Second important thing, when we are creating the Google meeting, how to take the attendance of the student. Let's say I have started a Google meeting. Google meeting, as we are taking the lectures, we are having the Google Meet for the lectures. Let's say I start a new meeting. It will open. I off the camera as well as mic. So I join the meeting. So it is asking copy joining information. Here I copy this link and send to the students who want to join my class. Here one important thing, as here I am only the participant in the meeting, no one is there, so it shows only my name. For attendance, you go to the Google and put here meet attendance. When you click on this, it will show meet attendance. You click on here, as I have already added it into my Chrome, so it is asking remove from the Chrome. But when you are using it first time, it is asking add to the Chrome. So when you add it to the Chrome, this type of link is open at the time of your meeting. When this shows add sheet, this shows new sheet, and when you click on here, a spreadsheet will open. This is your attendance. As here I am only the participant, it shows only my name. It shows the joining time, it shows the left time, the duration, everything. So at before leaving the meeting, you should click on this and the Excel sheet of your attendance will be generated. So need not to do by taking oral call. So just make a spreadsheet, and by clicking on this link you have the Excel sheet of the attendance. And second important thing, you have to on all these buttons on, and this is auto scroll. It should also on the on mode. Why this? Because when you are having the large number of participants, as only on this screen it shows only 10 to 20 participants, but if you are having the large number of audience, so it is have to scroll all the participants, and it will create the Excel of 50, 40, 100 participants. So I can show you the attendance of my lecture, and this Excel is saved in your Google Drive. Right now I'm showing you the wait. All the sheets are means day by day, let's say today's attendance, yesterday attendance, or tomorrow's attendance, all will collected at one place. Let's say this shows my today's lecture attendance, above the first name of the host and rest of the participants. So this is how you can take the attendance on the Google Meet, one thing. Second thing, there are many other options also. Second option is, which is important for the teacher, is the Jamboard. Jamboard means when you are having this, go to the Google Apps, when you scroll it down, there is a option Jamboard. You click on here, means sometimes we want to write something on the board. As a teacher, we always need something to write, or something we want to describe by writing, or we want to write some symbol. As one of my colleagues said, I want to write something, but I am not having the option to write. So this is the best option. So when you click on here, this whiteboard will open. So there are many options. Pen, you can use the pen as I want to write something. If you are having the touch screen, you can write it better. Otherwise with mouse, there is some problem. This is eraser. You can use the eraser to erase the content. This is the select button, and this is you can stick notes. You have something in the Word file, you can paste it here. Then you can add the images, you can draw the things. Let's say you want to draw the circle, you want to add the text. Let's say you want to add, this is a circle. So this way you can use it. This is the laser, you can highlight. Let's say you want to say, this students, this is a circle, we can draw this thing like this. So this is the option of the whiteboard in the Google Meet itself. So when you are sharing your screen with the students, you can show the whiteboard then. Fine. Next is background. You can change the background, you can have the dots, you can have the grid, many other options. You can zoom it. Let's say I want to zoom this circle, I can zoom it. Fine. So this is how I can use the whiteboard. I want to clear, so I can clear. There are three dots on this side. If I click on this, I can rename it. Here the untitled, but I can name it. I can download it as a PDF, I can save it as an image, I can remove it, make a copy. So these are the options for using the whiteboard. This is the inbuilt option in the Google Apps called the जैम बोर्ड. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग फॉर द फैकल्टी हु वॉन्ट्स टू राइट समथिंग ऑन द बोर्ड. थर्ड इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग विच आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस विद द फैकल्टी, आई कम बैक टू द गूगल मीट. Sometimes, as I am facing the problem, when I am presenting something with the students, I am not able to look at them. Means, let's say, when I am presenting something, let's say, I start presenting. I am a presenter. My screen is. This type of screen will open. Fine. So how I can see what the students are here, what chat they are doing? So the important thing is that this type of screen will open. So there is some adjustment to look at the Google Meet window as well as to share the content. Just do the adjustment of your second window. As I am my main screen, Google screen is wider and other sharing screen is smaller. So on this side I can check the chats, I can check the students, I can check the share the screen as well. So this is another important point which I think I am facing the problem and I find out the best solution for this. And the third one is, I'm stop sharing. And third problem is means to see the reactions of the students. For this we are having the another option. As we are having the meet attendance, we are having the option node reaction for Google Meet. Node reaction for Google Meet. This is the another extension when yes, node extension. When I click on this, I do the add to the Chrome and it will appear on my Google Meet. As here you have seen the reactions. If I want to say, students, do you understand, thumbs up, then they will do this reaction. Hand raise, anybody wants to ask the question, he will do the hand raise or another reactions also. Fine. So but the students on the other hand, as I am adding it, but the students can also add this node reaction to their Google Meet also. So tell your students to add this thing. The fourth thing is to add Google Grid. Google Google Meet. Google Grid. This will open and I will add it to my Chrome. When you add it to your Chrome, you can see the screen like this. All the participants on one screen, you can see all the participants on your screen. Fine. So these are the things which I want to tell with share with you. First one is how to create the Google Classroom. Second is how to use the Jamboard, and third one is Google Meet attendance, and fourth one is this Google node reactions, and fifth one is Google Meet grid view. So do all these things to make your classes more enjoyable and more comfortable. Hope you like this video, and if you like it, please do subscribe my YouTube channel and like it. Thank you so much for viewing.